Home or from wherever you are watching me, I just want to declare over your life today. It's a new season, it's a new moment. All the things have passed away. Behold, the Lord is bringing new things upon your life in Jesus' name. I am Dr. Cebisile Msomi, and it is always a joy for me to be coming into your homes. I'm very excited about what the Lord is going to do to you in your life and what He has done in my life. When I look back at what the Lord has done in me, the transformation and the change, I can only say to Him, Father, I love you and I'm so thankful. And I hope what He has done in me, He will also do in you, because He is a loving God. He doesn't want anybody to perish, but He wants everybody to be saved. Having said that, today I hope you're going to be blessed and you're going to learn a lot. We have met people in our lifetime, even in our days, who say, I'm saved and I love God with all of my life, with all of my heart. But it seems like God has forgotten me. It's like God has His own people. He has His own favorite people. It's like He doesn't care about me, because no matter what I do, nothing seems to get right. Have you ever heard people say that, or you are one of those people who say, I tithe, I give, I serve, but my life is upside down? Has the devil stolen your rest? Are you troubled? Are you bound? But I want to say to you today, if you watch this program and you claim it for yourself, you claim the anointing that you are going to watch for yourself, and the Lord will set you free. The Bible says, by faith we receive. The Bible says, only by faith we'll be able to please God. And faith is to have an assurance of things that are not seen. So now, just believe. Claim back your rest and believe God that He's going to set you free today, and a new season will be upon your life in Jesus' name. Let's go to the demonstration, and I hope you will be blessed. Amen.
Madam.
Ma'am.
Yebo, Baba.
He's dead.
Nawe umona ukulandele.
Envy is after you.
Ngifuna ukuqala la eqale khona uMama Kumbi.
I want to start where Mrs. Kumbi started off.
If you know, or rest.
I want you to rest. By sitting in your chair of dominion and ruling as in right now. Life was cruel towards you.
Cool.
Very.
Ibifuna ngaphansi komhlabathi.
It wanted you dead. You should be skeletons by now. But mercy said no. It said no. And it's not going to allow it. Even the devil knows that he did not permit it. And he will never permit it.
You are
not
going
to, there is nobody who will be hurt and you, and nothing is going to be broken. In this land that you who dominate and rule, I know right now you're stricken by fear. Actually, it's not you who's stricken by fear. It's the one who is afraid of losing you. After so much work, it cannot just be in vain. But it will be like that. It will be in vain. You have cried your tears. They even
attack
even your body, and it bleeded. You got sick. Everything happened. Today it is the time for your rest. As you are seated and rest. The trumpets of Jubilee have been blown for all the captive to be set free.
Now,
and you are worthy for Jubilee. You have been cleansed by the blood of Jesus and filled by the power of the Holy Spirit. You believe the word of God. You are led by the Spirit of God. So as from today, the Son is setting you free. You must be free indeed. This word should be fulfilled over your life. That if the Son sets you free, you shall be free indeed.
Who
have the power? Who said it is complete? And the hem of a temple was torn. And the dead came to life. And they were seen from multitude. If he say you are free indeed, if he spoke and he saw the blind, if he spoke and the one who had leprosy
was healed.
Lazarus came out from the tomb
and
was smelling. Who can stop that? I believe that when Jesus speaks,
it's
over your life. It is the time of liberty for the children of the kingdom. We cannot be carried by people's word that envy us. Unable to progress as the children of the kingdom.
It is our prayer, Dr. Suoane's prayer, that you are freed in all spheres of your life. And we will continue praying for you. You can send us your prayer request on the numbers that you see on the screen, or write us on the email, or call our offices, and we will be glad to pray for you. And we also would like to invite you to partner with us and support us with your prayers and with your finances. And if you want to be the part and support Dr. Suoane Mthethwa, Mount Zion Carnation, Suoane Msomi Ministries, with your financial support, you can also contact our offices and we'll give you all the details. And also, as you see them on the screen, we are in the month of July, Men's Month, Father's Month. And also, we are on a month where we will be having our second prophetic school. It's a reminder to those who attended the first time, but we also invite you, if you haven't attended, you are never late. You can attend this one so that you'll be able to learn more about prophecy and prophetic ministry, and that you'll be enhanced and you'll receive an impartation from the man of God, Dr. Suoane Msomi. Here is the information on the screen, and you can call our offices for more information. We would like to have your presence in Jesus' name. So now let's go back to the demonstration again. Those that God set free, they are free indeed. Believe that and receive it for yourself. For those who are tormented by the ancestry spirit, this is your day. And I know that you will be free. Some of you will cough this thing out. Some of you will feel heat coming over your life. Some of you will vomit it out. Don't panic. It's the deliverance, because God is mindful of you and he loves you. No matter what you've done, where you've been, he wants to save your life and give you rest in Jesus' name. Amen.
There is no ancestral spirit. I get irritated when it seems as if the devil has more power compared to God. Compared to God. The Bible says, the Son says, you free, you shall be free indeed. If the Son sets you free, you shall be free indeed. We won't be played by demons and witch doctors and thieves and the devil. They are being set free. The prophet of
trumpets have been blown. If the Son set you free, you shall be free indeed. There is nobody that can keep you bound or enslave you or keep you captive. Let this word be fulfilled right now. Every ancestral spirit that is bounding people right now, by the power Jesus have given me, let it all come out. Let it all come out. Allow it. Release that. I said release that.
Busha is iziba. Busha imisamo.
Right now.
There is no spirit that hates an African person like an ancestral spirit. I will count to three.
Bonke laba bavinjwe nababanjwe nabaqhilazwe umoya wamadlozi.
All those who are hindered and enslaved by the spirits of ancestors.
Namandiki namandayi namawathwasizizwe.
Whether amandiki namandawo or whatever.
Hambamawake uyana wamnikela.
And mamlambo. Or the giants. I'll counsel three. They are all going to be set free. Because the Son is setting you free.
One.
In Jesus' name.
Two.
In Jesus' name.
Three.
In Jesus' name.
You are free in Jesus' name.
This is the day of liberty. How are you feeling? I feel a breeze on my waist. I felt something moving on my waist and my back. The time doctor said I must place my hand on my waist, but now it's no more. I just feel this breeze.
Kosingisi mamisele. Endaweni elidundu, endaweni ephakeme, kusingise phezulu. Madam,
ma'am,
congratulations.
Ngiyakuhalalisela.
Congratulations.
Ngiyakuhalalisela.
One more thing.
Into nje yinye.
One more thing.
Into nje yinye sele.
I want you to do.
Engifuna ukuthi uyenze.
This one is not your battle alone.
Le akusiyona impi yakho wedwa.
When I look at Iskawini.
Mengibheka ngibheka Iskawini.
I see gold, diamonds, jewelry, rivers, tree which have fruits.
Kibona iithelo, ihlahle neithelo, ama jewelry, ama golide.
As we come to the end of our program, I just want to invite you to receive Jesus Christ as your savior. He is the only hope for this generation and age. Just receive him and have hope for the future and have eternal life. If you want to do that, you can just say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I receive you as my savior. I confess my sins, forgive me, and wash me with your precious blood. And if you've said that, I just want to assure you, you are saved in Jesus' name. You don't need to say big words, but this simple prayer is powerful to save you from death and give you eternal life. And I also want to pray for you at home. Just agree with me, whatever the situation, whatever the problem, whatever the challenges, I will pray for you. I want to pray for that one who is under the spirit of depression. You have lost hope and you're just thinking about killing yourself. Mother, Jesus is here. And he is speaking to you right now. And he just wants, he's saying to you, he loves you. I love you. Don't kill. Don't give up. I am beside you. And he says, I am closer to those whose hearts are broken. And he wants to comfort you. Doesn't matter what has happened. I know it's difficult, but the Lord wants to comfort you. Just release that pain. Just release those people, and the Lord wants to do a new thing in your life. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for this mother who's just lost hope. I know, Father, she has been hurt so many times and she thinks, what's the use? Father, I pray for the breakthrough. I pray for healing in her soul in Jesus' mighty name. Your spirit of depression, I command you to leave her right now in Jesus' mighty name. You have no right and no part to torment her in Jesus' name. You will not kill her. She will not die. And God is turning her life around right now as I speak in Jesus' name. As I speak, the fire of God is coming upon you. That bondage, that depression is being broken over your life, and your situation is being changed in Jesus' name. Every situation is being changed in Jesus' name. Just believe. Amen. Father, we thank you. We love you and we honor you. We love you, viewers. It's about time where we say we leave you and we love you. See you next time. May the Lord bless you and keep you in Jesus' name. Amen.